sprout-up scientists, and welcome back to our third and final video. First, let's do a quick recap on what we've learned so far. Can you tell me the three parts of a water cycle? That's right, we have evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. We also learned about watersheds. A watershed is basically a natural system that allows water from the mountains to flow through communities and back into the ocean. Do you remember the big word that we learned last time? That's right, it's infrastructure. Infrastructure is a system that we build to help manage our environment, like water and roads. And we call human infrastructure that mimics or copies our environment green infrastructure. So, over the last two episodes, we've talked all about water. We learned how it flows through our communities, why it's important that we have access to clean water, and how we can build systems to help manage our water resources. Today, we're going to talk about the importance of everyone in our communities having access to clean water, and how we, as individuals, can help protect our water resources.
Let's talk about environmental stewardship. Stewardship is the actions that we take to take care of something. So environmental stewardship refers to the actions we take care of our environment. We can take many actions in our homes, at school, and all throughout our day to help take care of our water. Here in California, we can have long periods of drought, which are long periods of time with no rain. This means that it's so important for us to conserve or save water. When we conserve water, we are only using what we need. Let's go around the house together and find ways that we can conserve water.
First up, the bathroom. We all use water to brush our teeth when we wake up and before we go to bed. One way to conserve water in the bathroom is to take shorter showers. Another way we can conserve water while brushing our teeth is turning off the faucet while we're brushing.
Let's do an experiment to see how much water we use when we brush our teeth. First off, go to your bathroom and grab a bowl that you'll put underneath the faucet. Grab a toothbrush, toothpaste, and two measuring cups for water. A small and a big one might be helpful. For the beginning of this experiment, you will leave the water faucet on while you brush your teeth. Set your timer on to 1 minute and keep brushing while the water fills up the bowl. Once the time's up, stop the timer. And now you will use your measuring cup to see how much water is in the bowl. That's 2 cups. We'll pour it into the pitcher. Now we're at 7 cups. And do you see that there's even still water left in the bowl? We used a lot of water while leaving the faucet running for a minute. Now we're going to do the experiment over again, but instead we're going to turn the faucet off. Then set our timer to 1 minute again and keep brushing our teeth. Once the time's up, we'll grab our measuring cup and start measuring the water that's left in the bowl. Here's how much water we used without the faucet on. And here's how much water we used with the faucet on. So, make sure to turn the faucet off when you brush your teeth, and you will save lots of water. Now let's head to the kitchen. If we're helping a grown-up wash the dishes or wash some fruits and veggies, what are some ways that we can help conserve water? Maybe after washing your fruits and veggies, you could use that leftover water to water your plants. Another way that we can be environmental stewards is by making sure our water systems remain clean. Remember in the last video how we talked about watersheds and green infrastructure? We saw how water flows from the mountains down into our communities and eventually into our San Francisco Bay. Because of the way water flows through our communities, it's incredibly important to make sure that our streets don't have any litter that would be picked up by the water.
Hey, sprout-up scientists, Tadpole here. Throughout these three videos, we've learned all about how water cycles throughout our environment, why it's important for all people and living things to have access to clean water, and how we can use green infrastructure to help take care of our water and our environment. This is all part of a bigger idea called environmental justice. Let's break down what that means. The environment is a word we use to describe everything around us, from our school, home, neighborhood, and communities, to the parks, waterways, plants, and animals all around us. Justice means fairness. So, environmental justice means that everyone, regardless of the amount of money they have, the color of their skin, or their cultural background, has a healthy and safe environment to live in. Now, let's learn about some ways that people are focusing on environmental justice in our community. Over now to Water Lily so we can hear more.
Thanks, Tadpole. Water Lily here, and today I'm at Coyote Creek in Santa Clara County. Our friends at Valley Water are working on some projects here at Coyote Creek. Over the last few years, Coyote Creek has been flooding, which means that the water flowing through the creek rises too high, and water ends up on places that don't normally have water, like our streets and homes. At Coyote Creek, different people are working together to help build infrastructure like walls, roads, and bridges so that the community next to Coyote Creek can stay dry and travel safely around the creek. Let's take a walk together and look for some signs of environmental justice here at Coyote Creek.
Valley Water and their partners have added a lot of things to this part of the Coyote Creek Trail to make it a fun, usable space for residents of Santa Clara County. There are bike racks for people to store their bikes if they'd like to keep them there. Just make sure you use a lock. There is a box with pet waste bags for people to pick up. There is a trash can, as well as a bench and some trees to provide shade, which is super nice to use on a hot day like today. Here is a view of Coyote Creek from a bridge that crosses over the creek, protecting the road from flooding. Here you can see the Coyote Creek Trail is built up on the top of a hill. This allows the trail to be used for hiking, walking, and biking, even when it's wet and rainy and the creek is full of water. At this part of the Coyote Creek Trail, there have been trees planted to also help prevent flooding, because the trees' roots and the soil around the trees will help absorb the water. You can also see that the trees that are planted here are irrigated with recycled water. So this isn't the same as fresh water that we drink and use in our homes, but it's water that has been used and then reused to water these trees. Using recycled water to irrigate plants is a great example of water conservation, because we get to use the same water twice for human use. As you keep walking on the Coyote Creek Trail, you can find this solar panel, which is collecting renewable energy that can be used here. This is a great alternative to a diesel generator, which would create energy but release air pollution that could make the air in this area less healthy to breathe. All of the infrastructure that we found walking around Coyote Creek today helps mitigate flooding around the creek, or helps prevent the creek from flooding, so that the community can use these walking trails and roads safely.
Before we go, let's brainstorm some ways that we can become environmental stewards. First, remember that it's not just your responsibility to work toward a healthy environment and green infrastructure. You can ask your friends and family for help, or even ask for their ideas on change. Another way to fight environmental hazards and injustices is by bringing green infrastructure into your own home. You can do this by planting plants in your front yard and bringing some nature into your neighborhood. We hope you guys had as much fun as we did in these last three videos. And if you'd like to check out more videos on the environment and sustainability, feel free to check us out at our website, sproutup.org. And thank you to Valley Water for supporting these videos and bringing clean water into Santa Clara County. Thank you so much, and I hope to see you next time.